Hello Cloud Gurus and welcome back to another AWS This Week, where we bring you all the goodies from the past week of AWS announcements. This week, AWS announced that Amazon CodeGuru is generally available, AWS established an aerospace and satellite solution space unit, Amazon RDS Proxy is now generally available, the AWS documentation gets a feature so cool, I'm going to talk about it for at least 20 seconds. And we announce our guru of the week. It's AWS This Week with me, Nick Triantafilou. Kicking off this week is the announcement that Amazon CodeGuru, no relation, which was announced at reInvent last year, is now generally available. Amazon CodeGuru is a developer tool which uses machine learning to help improve your code quality, and it can even identify an application's most expensive line of code. CodeGuru has two components, the reviewer and the profiler. The reviewer will scan code for critical issues, identify bugs, and recommend how to fix them. The profiler will help discover expensive lines of code, by which we mean inefficient code, and it gives recommendations on how to improve the code and how to save money. It's a really awesome service and it's free for 90 days, so I suggest all developers should check it out. Next up, AWS have established a new aerospace cloud unit called Aerospace and Satellite Solutions. There are job listings for many different space subsectors like rocket launchers, human spaceflight support, robotic systems, mission control, and loads more. Space is definitely something AWS have been putting a lot of effort into over the past few years, as this ties in with their AWS Ground Station service announced in 2018 as well. If you're interested in both the cloud and space, I think it's going to be a very exciting future. Okay, next up we have the announcement that Amazon RDS Proxy is now generally available. Launched at reInvent in 2019, RDS Proxy is a fully managed and highly available proxy for RDS that makes applications more scalable, secure, and resilient to database failures. RDS Proxy allows applications to pool and share connections established with the database, which improves efficiency and application scalability. AWS have said RDS Proxy reduces the client recovery time after a failover by up to 79% for Aurora MySQL and up to 32% for RDS for MySQL, which is huge. And authentication can all be managed through AWS Secrets Manager and AWS Identity and Access Manager integrations. It can be enabled for most applications with no code change, and there's no provisioning. You simply pay per vCPU of the database instance the proxy is enabled on. Awesome. Finally this week, I get to my favorite announcement, and this one is huge. The AWS documentation now has a dark mode for both text and code snippets. And as an engineer and sysadmin who has used dark mode for everything I can for as long as I can think of, this is a really welcome addition. We really appreciate the AWS documentation team and everyone involved with this, and we look forward to the entire AWS console having the same option soon too, please. All right. Time for everybody's favorite guru of the week. This week, our winner is Giyok Kunpo, a security specialist at Accenture in Singapore. Congratulations, a t-shirt, sticker, and hand signed card are on their way to you. And assuming it's still on, you're also in the draw to win a free ticket to reInvent in 2020. If you'd like to win guru of the week, be sure to check out this week's question of the week on our forum link below. All right, that's all for me this week. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.